All right, we are on these Mount Sneffels West Ridge route. Let's start the music while I climb up some spires to nowhere, and I'll give you the beta once we're down. Well, I hope you had as much fun with that excursion to nowhere as I did. But alas, it's time to get back to the main route. The Sneffels West Ridge route is rated a Class 3, and if you want, you can make it It makes some sections of Class 4, but there isn't really a super technical section that you can stumble into. I'm calling this climb the Reverse Sunrise, because I took the West Ridge up and the standard East Ridge down. I don't have any video of the descent, because it's really just two big gullies, and gullies are boring. Most of the climb is navigating up Talus, as you probably have seen, until the summit is in sight, and once that summit gets in sight, it becomes very Class 3-ish on great stable rock. There wasn't much loose rock at all in this one. It's a very good Class 3 to hit after you maybe get a few under your belt. If you leave them from the lower four-wheel drive trailhead, it's only about like 10 miles and 3,500 feet of elevation gain round trip, meaning you can kind of sleep in a bit and still be out of there by early afternoon. Also, Sneffels will become one of your favorite mountains, seeing as how you can see it dominating the skyline as you're approaching from vehicle through Montrose or anywhere north or west. And it just looks so imposing and awesome. You'll feel great every time you see it from town, which is always makes these hikes more memorable. So what if I was just a pizza? So this next part here was the sketchiest part of the climb for me, because the snow wasn't necessarily snow. It's in a part of the mountain that doesn't get much sun, so late in the afternoon it heats up, it melts a little bit, and then it freezes into ice, so you couldn't even dig your boot into it. So I was very carefully tiptoeing on the snow at a 45 degree angle to hit what is, if you're taking the normal route, just a gully up top, but I don't have fun in gullies. So I took the little rock rib separating the two gullies you can take. And this is actually probably the steepest part on the whole ascent. And it was the funnest climbing up until the very final summit push. You can keep it more Class 3-ish if you'd like, but where's the fun in that? Anyhow, enjoy the only thing resembling a wall on the entire route. Let's go.
news for you. WrestleFest.
Legend reigns. Two sweet wins, weeks is all that.
passion will push you to move. The obstacle mentions referring to you should know we're never, ever, ever gonna quit. This is our night, this is our time, this is our chance at feeling alive. Because chaotic minds can't think. This is our night, this is our time, this is our chance at feeling alive. Cause everyone knows the stars come out at night.
Once we gain the ridge for the final summit push, I think the video here doesn't do justice how cool the views were. This is one of my favorite mountains ever, and I'm going to have to come back and do it again just because it was, like, the sky just seemed magical. Which sounds weird, because you really did have to be there to understand it. But I hope you enjoy it and inspires you to actually hit Sneffels, which, even though it has a very weird name, is one of Colorado's gems, especially for 14ers.
Yeah. and the thoughts that were tucked away. So that the door can be open again. In your darkest memories lies the answer if you dare to find it. Don't let hope become a memory. When you think of this forsaken, listen to me now.
And here's the money shot, the final summit push on Snuffles. Personally, this is one of my favorite summit pushes, even though nothing is too overly technical, and it's really not that exhausting of a route. It's just the whole vibe of the area is just awesome. It steals the show. It's such a cool area. You'll feel cool climbing it, you know. And if you don't feel cool on the summit push, is it really worth it? You know? Anyway, enjoy the summit music.
lost, well, as a place that the damned call home. A place where the virtuous hide in fear. A place we see only in our nightmares. A place where the sun is silent. Imprisoned beneath the world, where the soulless dwell. As a place that the damned call home. A place where the virtuous hide in fear. A place we see only in our nightmares. A place where the sun is silent.